A mysterious man arrives in a small town in Scotland. Rachel Heggie awakens from her nightmare just before her alarm goes off. She discovers a raven feather in her bed. She's just finished her morning workout, and we can see scars on her body from a long time ago. She leaves the cheap hotel room where she lives for work, and as she walks away, we notice the light turning on in her room and the silhouette of a man inside. Rachel sees a man, and a raven feather falls from him. The young driver, who is going far too fast, is unable to come to a halt and runs over the mysterious man. The young driver, Caesar Sargasson, gets out of his car, but the man is nowhere to be found. Rachel arrests him, leaving his car stranded in the middle of the deserted street. At the police station, she is greeted by Sergeant Jim McCready, who charges Caesar with reckless driving. Heggie radios PCs, Jennifer Mundy, and Jack Warnock to find the victim before taking Caesar to the cells, where he joins his teacher, Mr. Ralph Beswick, arrested for beating his wife. Mundy and Warnock, having located the man Caesar struck, bring him to the station, mute, covered in scratches, and carrying only a notebook with lists of names. Heggie calls Dr. Duncan Hume to examine him. However, during the examination, Hume has a flashback and attempts to kill his patient for allegedly knowing what Hume has done. Hume is placed in a cell, and the unknown man is identified as having the fingerprints of an elderly man who died more than 20 years ago. He makes several references to Old Testament justice before McCready has a flashback and angrily orders Heggie and Mundy to place him in cell 6. Mundy has a flashback to beating a prisoner alongside Warnock. McCready sends Mundy and Warnock to Hume's house to find his wife before driving to his own house. The sergeant is driving like crazy, and he believes he has spotted Six in the back seat with white eyes. He drinks while driving, and a bloodied arm emerges for a split second at the side of the road. Beswick wonders why Six remembers his name. Rachel remembers being raped. She controls herself and examines the black book. She looks into David Brundridge, a.k.a. Acid Bath Murderer, and Brian Heflington, a.k.a. The Whale, both serial killers. There are others, but they are all dead. Whatever Six does affects Beswick, the wife beater. Six strikes a match, and the shadow of a hand appears ominously. The CCTV monitor goes dark, and the radio sounds, so Rachel does not check on the convicts. She instructs Jack and Jen to enter Beswick's residence to check on his wife. An alarm sounds, and Beswick beats himself against the door until he is a bloody mess. Caesar claims that Beswick tried to kill him. Rachel lets him out, and Beswick collapses to the ground. Duncan says he can help him. Rachel lets Duncan out so he can help Beswick. Jen and Jack discover the body of Beswick's deceased wife, who has been left hanging to die. MacReady is also attempting to dispose of a body, a bloodied young guy who used to be his sweetheart, Mulvey. He drank and killed him with his bare hands. Duncan gets aggressive and weird, and Rachel punches him while feeling dizzy and bewildered by her own visions of Dr. Hume's intentions. He appears to be a psychopath who murdered his wife and children. McCready is attempting to dispose of his ex-lover's body, and he is terrified by his own vision of Six simply staring at him. Six can make a match float. When Rachel warns him, "Go to hell," he responds, "All the devils are in this police station." Rachel tries to leave, but Six whistles the same sound Rachel's raper used to make while having sex with her. Finally, the young Rachel breaks free and quietly wanders away, fleeing that ordinary-looking house. Rachel tries to remain composed and hold back her tears. McCready speaks with Rachel while sitting on a bed with blood-stained covers. He also grabs a firearm from beneath the bed. Duncan is also justifying himself by claiming that patients die all the time from natural causes. Six claims that he is giving Caesar a last chance to remember. He had ran over an already bloodied lady. Her condition deteriorated as a result of the collision, although he could have rescued her by taking her to the hospital. Instead, he fled away, Rachel puts aside a crossword with the word death on it. She is continuing checking Six's black book. Jen and Jack return. Beswick's body is covered with a blanket. Jen swears a lot and is angry. Six watches at Caesar, who wants to confess to Jen and Rachel, but they are too busy, so Jen instructs Caesar to shut up. Six claims that he is in the business of revenge, not salvation. Rachel paces up and down, trying to make sense of everything. Dr. Hume claims that he discovered a higher calling. Six proposes he hang himself. The black book opens to Warnock's page. He pretends to beat and kill a prisoner, assisted by Six, who stings himself with a match that now resembles a nail. Warnock justifies the murder of the prisoner. Jack and Jen defend the murder, claiming that they take care of our own. Rachel gives in, but she is quite upset. Caesar confesses to Rachel. Six claims that the girl died 2 minutes earlier. Rachel overhears Jen claiming she was having sex with Jack and trying to concoct plausible stories. She interrupts them, preventing them from making out. Jen and Jack attack Rachel, but she defends herself well. Jack tries to strangle her, but then MacReady enters, clothed in barbed wire and shooting everyone in sight. Jack has died. Jen and Rachel lock themselves and injured MacReady, who now limps. MacReady bursts the door and shoots Jen, who can still escape with Rachel. Outside, MacReady surrounds the station with petrol before setting fire to it. Rachel opens the cells of Six and Caesar. He responds, "Thanks, but I think I can handle him." MacReady fires at the fleeing Rachel, Caesar, and Jen, but fails. Jen is murdered by shattered glass at a door. Six stays quiet in his cell. MacReady shoots Rachel in the shoulder and kills Caesar. Six remains tranquil. MacReady is still alive, though he is severely burned. Rachel murders him. Rachel exits the police station and falls on the ground. Six follows suit, cautiously walking out and offering her a smoke. At this point, Six collects the sinner's souls. He crosses them out of his book. Raven's crooning can be heard. Six wants Rachel to assist him. Six had knocked on Rachel's torturer door, and he was a witness to Rachel's fierce survivor spirit. Six claims that he will be content with Rachel. Rachel replies yes to helping him with his responsibilities. The kiss against the backdrop of a burning police station. "That's my girl," he says. A raven is heard.